Hey y'all, how's it going? It's Army Queen slash Hospitality Queens here in UK Positive Pinky. So I'm on the mend, even though it may not sound like it. Yeah, I've been sick. So far, it just seems to be the flu. I love how I say it's just the flu, because it's not just the flu. Like, nah, but I'm doing what I can to like heal from it, because yeah, if I'm not careful, this could turn into a sinus infection. Like, a drop a hat if I don't like if I don't treat it right away. But nah, it's kind of scary how I say as much as I say the word fuck. Like, that's kind of scary. Like, it's like an airy sentence. I can't myself. But nah, like, at least I'm not hoarse like last time. Like, you know what I just realized is lately I feel like every voice recital I'm always sick before. Because in summer, because the summer I had a really bad sinus infection, and like it was like, and somehow I pulled through with like the voice recital then, and I nailed it. Like, and speaking of saving all my love, that's what I did for that, and I nailed it. But nah, and I did Bushel My Pet too, that was fun. And then December, I don't know, I had some kind of cold, you know. Luckily, that time, a rare instance, it didn't turn into, well, I shouldn't say rare, because you know. But yeah, luckily it didn't turn into a sinus infection then, like it has past times. But you know, sometimes you just gotta see how things go, you know, play it by ear. Like, I feel so loopy, and I'm not even on, well, I am on other drugs, but like ones that are prescribed. Okay, why am I even saying that? But nah, it's time to switch gears to Motown, because nah, that's where my roots be. Like, I'm back to my roots. Nah. You know, just because I'm white don't mean I can't do Motown, you know? Like, I can do Motown too. You know, just because I think for someone who's Irish Catholic, I can do Motown pretty damn well. Like, I mean, hey, how many Irish Catholics can say, okay, let me stop. But no, in all seriousness, because like, nah, but let me just get into it. Like, let me not do a long documentary introduction, because I've been there, done that. Like, okay. All right, I'm gonna do Sitting on the Dock of the Bay. Say, now I may be a millennial, but I know my Motown. You know, like, how many millennials can actually say they actually know who Otis Redding is and they've actually heard his songs? You know, like, come on, get with the program, people. And like, you know, I know who the Supremes are. I definitely know who Whitney Houston is, because let me tell you, I've like, you know, I sang at least four of her songs, talent shows in high school. And at this graduation, yeah, like first year of college, I did a gap program called Thames Academy, and then they asked me to sing the graduation, so I did Greatest Love of All. And let's see, just going through my sing-along, like, for real. But nah, like, high school, so first it was like, the junior year of high school, I did two Whitney song, I Will Always Love You. And let me tell you, that is not an easy one to do. Like, that's like operatic. Like, I don't care what nobody says. Like, people can look at me like, oh, you can't do opera for shit. But nah, that's operatic. I don't care what nobody says. Like, it's not the same as like Phantom of the Opera, but it's got some fluctuation. Let me just say that. But nah, like, and like, you know, then I, and then I think that spring I did. Oh yeah, so let me backtrack. So then what was that? Oh yeah, see, my memory sucks. Nah, I don't know. Today I'd be feeling disoriented, like at work. I'm like, ugh. Like, I'm here, but I'm not. Is this paranormal activity? Okay, let me stop. Nah, but in all seriousness, okay, why am I drawing a blank? Okay, like, so I Would Always Love You. Oh wait, I know, I got it mixed up. So first it was Saving All My Love for You. That's where it all began, okay? Nah, I remember, like, I mean, like, okay. And then I Will Always Love You. And then senior year, let's see, senior year I did I do, well, I know in the collaboration for Vocal Jazz. Good times, but man, it was a trip sometimes. I'll tell you right now. But it was fun. It was a good experience to learn to collaborate with people, you know. But yeah, I did I'll Believe in You and Me from The Preacher's Wife, and at the time I had never seen that movie, and now like it's like my go-to movie, especially when I'm sick. Like that's the first movie I watch when I'm sick, like, you know, like whether it's the flu or sinus infection or whatever it is. Nah, I could never get sick of watching that movie, but now it's like I watched it so many times, like I know what's gonna happen. It's like, okay. Nah, but it's got some good humor in it. Like if I'm you know, having one of those days, I can always count. Like my favorite lines is when, you know, a preacher is like, "Do you mind?" Well, and that's not exactly how we say it, but nah, that's what I want to say to a lot of people that I interact with. I'm gonna just say it like that. I'm gonna not get into it, but but nah, I mean, I really do say, "Do you mind?" Because today, you know, I'm getting off work and people are in my way. It's like, and man, can we normalize how obnoxious teenagers are? It's like, find shit to do with your time. Like, for real. Like, nah, seriously, because they be so obnoxious. But then again, I was their age once. I was probably so obnoxious and loud when I was their age. But it's like, you know, it's interesting, like, when you see a perspective that you didn't know you could see before, you know what I'm saying? It's like when you don't realize how you used to be until someone does it to you, and then you're like, oh God, like, was I that bad? But nah, I mean, but anyway, so sorry, I got off track. And then, like, damn, what was the one I did? I swear I'm gonna end up with dementia. Yeah, this is why I need to kick the Diet Coke habit, but hey, like, the past couple of days, I had done good with no Diet Coke, you know, because I was at home, I was quarantined, so I didn't got no choice. Like, nah. But hey, better that than nothing. So, damn, what was it? It was like, I Believe in You and Me. What was the other one? Oh, I Want to Dance with Somebody. That was the one. I Want to Dance with Somebody Who Loves Me. And that's a really fun one, like, for real. Like, yeah, and then in college it was Greatest Love of All, and I did Someone Like You by Adele. And then my sophomore year of college, I did Teardrops on My Guitar. Like that's where it all began, I guess, technically. So, but yeah, so, all right, anyway, let me get into this. All right, sorry, long introduction.
Sitting in the morning sun. I'll be sitting when the evening comes, watching the ships roll in, watch them roll away again. Yeah, I'm just sitting on the dock of the bay, watching the tide roll away. Oh, I'm just sitting on the dock of the bay, wasting time. My home in Georgia, headed for the Fresco Bay, 'cause I had nothing to live for. Looks like nothing's gonna come my way, so I'm just gonna sit on the dock of the bay, watching the tide roll away. Oh, I'm just sitting on dock of the bay, wasting time. Look like nothing's gonna change. Everything still remains the same. I can't do what 10 people tell me to do, so I guess I'll remain the same. Yeah. Sitting here resting my bones. Yeah, this loneliness won't leave me alone. This 2,000 miles I roam, just to make this dock my home. Now I'm just gonna sit on the dock of the bay, watching the tide roll away. Oh, yeah. Sitting on the dock of the bay, wasting time. Roll away.